With all the volatility in the stock market and lots of concerns about the macro economy, are you seeing a slowdown yet in private equity deal making?
We're not really seeing a big slowdown. You know, there's momentary caution, no doubt. You know, when something big happens, market drops 300-400 points, there's momentary caution. We've had deals where we were doing due diligence, for example, for a private equity firm where when the market dropped a few hundred points, they said, we're going to hold for a week. So that is happening. But that deal got right back on track. So I don't think any big, you know, if you will, sea changes, macro changes are changing or pushing time. But clearly from moment to moment, you know, private equity deal guys are human too. You know, they're cautious when things are rocking and rolling a little bit.
Does this element of caution translate into more heightened due diligence?
No doubt. I mean, the more you think about or have some trepidation about the market, you know, kind of the more you sharpen your pencil and say, look, I know what I'm supposed to be looking at. Let's make sure we're looking at it, whether it's the legal side, the operational side, whatever it might be. And absolutely the things that get scrubbed the most are anything in the P&L where there's some projection of a significant change.
In that scrubbing process, in mm-hmm. due diligence, what are some of the mistakes that you've seen people make?
Wow, mistakes in due diligence, great question. Probably the biggest mistake is to fall in love with the deal. I think you have to stay professionally skeptical right up until the minute after you close. You know, so falling in love with the deal and, you know, doing a due diligence where you're trying to, where you ultimately, whether you intended to or not, spend your time confirming what you believed or wanted to believe, it is a big mistake. I think you've got to look at, with great skepticism, right, what you're being presented. And it's not because people are going to be dishonest, just because the nature of what you're getting into, you need to know what's up. You know, some key things to look at, anything that is steady state in the P&L, you want to scrub that hard and say, you know, can it change? Can it be better? Biggest area to look is anywhere where there's a significant improvement or change called. You know, sales are going up. Why? Where is it really going to come from? Why hasn't it happened before? You know, we're going to have much higher revenue. Do you really have the capacity to do that? You know, is all of the capital implied in making that, you know, that higher revenue really in place? You know, there's significant capital investments. Well, what's the ROI? How have they been scrubbed? How do you know? You know, I think you just got to look at anything that's changing and make sure that you understand if it will happen and why.